Hi, folks. I'm Richard Friedman, and welcome to another one of my singing political cartoons for March 12th, 2024. Every so often we get together, either do the countdown or a singing cartoon. So here I am tonight with a singing cartoon. And before we get started, I just wanted to introduce you to my latest book here, Richard's Best of 2023 Political Cartoons. There it is. And this is my first book that's in color. And I'm a little proud of it because it's the first, I did so many colored cartoons that I decided to basically write the book in color. And so here it is. You can see some of the drawings in color. Yeah. And it's it highlights the cartoon as it was meant to be, as I drew it. See, so you have here. Yeah. And all right, I don't want to get too much into this because you decide, you look at it and you'll see the sample cartoons if you go to my website. But here, this is just some of the cartoons in color. So I'm a little proud of that. Again, here's the book. There it is. And if you chose to purchase it, again, there's a link on my website, Richard's Books of Political Cartoons.com, or you can go to Amazon. So here now is my cartoon, singing cartoon, and this is based here on interaction between Marjorie Taylor Greene and the House Speaker Mike Johnson. And Marjorie Taylor Greene now, Johnson came to, they call her MTG, so they, Mike Johnson might have said, look here, MTG, if I'd like you to behave yourself a little tonight and cool it, you know, with the decorum, and because she has a reputation for yelling out. So he took her aside and spoke to her, and she said, well, that all depends upon what President Biden says tonight. What Johnson says doesn't mean anything. It's what President Biden says and her reaction that takes priority over the protocol of the situation of the State of the Union address, which is the whole nation broadcasted to the whole nation and the whole world. The whole world sees this. But America, everybody's looking, our friends, our enemies, you know, everybody's looking into to see what's going on here in America. So he did his best, but sure enough, Biden said something with respect to a terrible killing of a girl. That was a terrible thing. And I don't want to dwell into that because it's in all our hearts what happened to that young lady. And it's a terrible thing and it should never have happened. And the borders have to be fixed. But the question now is it putting, they had a bill passed by the Senate and it had some step in the right direction, but the Republicans don't want to take steps in the right direction. They want their cake and eat, they want everything all the way, you know? So the bill failed. So we're getting, the bottom line is we're not getting any improvement in the border, and Ukraine is on the borderline of losing this war if they don't get the aid they need to fight off the Russians there. So it all comes down to American security. America more secure if we continue to haggle over the border and over this important matter, but there has to be a meeting of the minds. And that's really in the interest of America. That's all I have to say about that. I said already too much. So here's my cartoon. Now, what happened here is that Marjorie Taylor Greene, basically said she wants it her way or the highway to Johnson, saying he is of no consequences. If President Biden says something she don't like and that depends on him, then that's what's going on. And he did say that about this immigration terrible thing that happened there, you know, with that killing. You know, and the man was not supposed, if the odds are, from everything I heard, had protocols, things been followed properly, he would not have been in the country. That's reportedly, reportedly. So it's very, very upsetting. And I'm not minimizing that, but this goes out to the whole world, you know? And so, I don't know. So if this would have happened at the Academy Awards, if Marjorie Taylor Greene was an actress, you know, and somebody said something she didn't like at the Academy Awards or something like that, she'd get up there and they couldn't, they probably would not be able to get her out of there. You know, they would have had to call the National Guard in to get Marjorie Taylor Greene out of the Academy Awards. They would have had to call up who knows what, the FBI, the National Guard, and who knows what they would have had to call in, tanks, who knows, to get, because she went to the left no matter what. You know, they would have had to carry her out. So so the Academy Award people are very lucky that Marjorie went into politics and not into acting. That's the bottom line on that one. So here she is now, and this is what she said. It all depends, it's up to President Biden what he says tonight. So here comes tonight. Now, here's Marjorie Taylor Greene, okay? And I'm gonna try to bring in the music. I hope I can get that. Okay, here it goes. Okay, here. This is the introduction. Tonight, tonight, President Trump's November victory begins tonight. Tonight, President Trump's November victory begins tonight. I heard Joe Biden stutter, and there's nothing for me but Trump, Trump, Trump. Always you as our best president, Trump. I saw you, then Nikki Haley and all others went away. Today, all day, I had a fantastic feeling a miracle would happen for me and Nancy Mace. And after your great win at the Supreme Court in that fake Colorado disqualification case, I know now I was right. Tonight, Ukraine is taking Russia's dynamite. Running out of ammo, but it is their fight. Tonight. America, sleep well tonight and dream of me in national security, keeping America safe with President Trump tonight. So here, I'm gonna let you read it. Here, read it. Read this, so you can get the full gist of it. Here, I'm gonna try to put it up so you can read it. There. Okay. Tonight, tonight. All right, folks, I want to thank you for watching another one of my singing cartoons. And God bless you. God bless America. And a prayer for all our troops fighting all over the world in dangerous places. And a prayer for the people of Gaza who are under this terrible bombardment. And a prayer for the hostages still with Hamas in these underground bunkers or tunnels, wherever they may be, a prayer for them and a prayer for peace, that someday perhaps a new generation of leaders will emerge and see the wisdom in respecting each other's views and having a peaceful resolution of this terrible dilemma and terrible conflict. And we pray for peace. We pray for the existing conditions to improve, for the hostages being released, and for the people of Gaza to be able to walk again in their streets, and those who have survived to go on with their lives, and a prayer for those who are lost. And that's all I can say is that, to me, whenever I see a dead Israeli or dead Palestinian, it's equivalent because it's dead innocent people. Dead innocent people who all they wanted to do was go about their business of living, and that was taken away from them. So that's all I have to say, folks. I'll say it again. God bless you. God bless America. And I'll see you next time. Take care, folks. Bye.